In this video, we'll graph the linear equation y equals x, and we're going to do it two ways. First, we'll put values in for x, and then find the corresponding y value, and then we'll take that point and we'll put it on our graph. After that, we'll look at the slope-intercept formula just to make sure we got the right answer. So let's start out. Let's say x is 0. If x is 0, y equals x, so y is 0. What if x were 1? Well, they're equal, so y is 1. How about x is negative 1, y equals negative 1. So these are the points that we'll graph for the linear equation y equals x. So let's go to x is 0, y is 0. So here's x is 0 right here, and y is 0, same place. So that's our first point. How about x is 1, and then y is 1. And finally, we have x is negative 1, and y is negative 1. And you can see all of these points are in a line. Let's put a line through it. And then we can put arrows to show this goes to infinity. We could have chosen any value to put in for x, and it would be on this line here. I just chose these because they fit nicely on the graph paper. And while I did 3 points, you could just do 2 points. I like doing 3 points because then if I make a mistake here, I'll usually catch it. Let's check our work with the slope-intercept formula. So we have y equals mx plus b. M, that's the slope, and b, that's the y-intercept, except there isn't anything out here. So what we could do is we could say y equals x plus 0. It's the same thing, now we just have this 0 out here, and that's going to be our y-intercept. So for the y-intercept, it's 0, we go to the y-axis, because the y-intercept, that's where the line crosses the axis. We're going to go down and find 0 right here, and there it is. So that's our y-intercept. For the slope, there's also nothing written in front of the x, but we assume there's a 1 there. And we could call this 1 over 1. That's still 1, but now we could say rise over run. So we're going to rise 1 and go over run 1. So rise over run. So we go to the y-intercept right here. We rise 1 and go over 1. Rise over run. Do it again. Up 1 over 1. And we could just keep doing that. All these points are going to be on the line. Likewise, we could go in the opposite direction. We could go down 1 and over 1 to the left. Down 1, over 1 to the left. And all of these points, they're going to be on our line. So that confirms that we have the correct graph for the equation y equals x. This is Dr. B, and thanks for watching.